So you guys, this is the box. So these are the boxes I got from YouTube. They even gave me lines. You know how to make material. So is it that was helping me with the material? What's this one? Tequila. Martini. But they don't have any recipes here. They should have two recipes now. For all these things. Which means? I wonder where they got these big potatoes from. Okay.
All of them.
Yes. You guys, we just finished having the meeting with YouTube and we made the veggie gumbo. I don't know if you watched my other video where I showed you how I made the Somali fried rice, but if you did, you will see that I talked about how they gave us two recipes. I did not know that I was supposed to cook the two recipes at the same time. Okay, so I cooked the rice for a video thinking I'll cook the rice and just come for the meeting with my already cooked rice. I actually missed the meal where they told us what we're supposed to do anyway. But thankfully I didn't cook the gumbo, so I cooked the gumbo with them. It tastes so delicious. I'm definitely going to try it another day. It's basically, I've cooked something similar just with different veggies, okay? In fact, not even once. I've cooked something similar a lot of times, but with different veggies. I don't add all this zucchini and the eggplant and all of that, but and okra. Okra was supposed to be inside, and the okra was supposed to just be chopped in half and put inside me. I've already rushed and cut. I told Elizabeth to help me cut the okra, like normal, how we cook okra soup. So I just put a little bit. I didn't put all the okra. The okra is still here. But it came out nice. It's not even drawing or anything because I was afraid of it, you know, being slimy, but it's not at all. And then afterwards, we now made martini. Is it martini we made at the what? One cocktail, sha. Tastes really good. I've given my husband his own. But yeah, it was such a fun event. I literally just ran into the kitchen and started working and started cooking. She started by 5 o'clock, so I was thinking that okay, since we didn't prep anything, we'll start prepping, you know, or yeah, everybody cut your veggies, everybody cut your potatoes. No, it was not like that though. I literally had to have Elizabeth and Uche, which is around with the kids, they literally had to help me sharp sharp. That was how I was able to get my gumbo ready in time. But yeah, I really enjoyed it. Like, kudos to YouTube, actually, like, they're so nice. They're so nice because I've had so much fun and it was really fun catching up with the other ladies. The ladies are so, not just ladies, guys are there as well, and they are so hilarious. Like, Mama Sherry, I don't know if you guys know Mama Sherry. If you used to watch Kitchen Nightmare, is it Kitchen Nightmare? That one that Gordon Ramsay used to go to people's kitchen and like restaurants and, you know, eat their food and find out what, you know, went wrong, why they're not doing as well. I remember watching that Mama Cherry's episode. I remember going to follow her from that episode because she was one of the best that he had reviewed. And trust me, Gordon Ramsay has entered like nonsense kitchens, like disgusting kitchens. His own was just, her own was just a management issue. So I can't even remember. But I know that her food was really good and Gordon Ramsay really liked her food. So I followed her from there. So she was our host. She's also a recipient of the, you know, YouTube Black Fund. So she's in my class. She's in my class. Anyway, so she's one that hosted, that taught us the gumbo recipe, while another lady taught us the Somali fried rice. Okay, so Mama Sherry is so hilarious. When they tell her, because she was talking so fast, I was just like, I felt like I needed 7 hands to do everything at once. When we now tell her slow down, she will now say, okay, now I am going to cut the tomato. She's hilarious. I'm probably like, what's so funny? But if you were there, you would laugh, sha. See my apron from YouTube. Anyway, today has been such an eventful day, so let me just go and relax, I beg. Ah, see you tomorrow. Makeup storage thing from one page on Instagram. I'm going to leave their name on the screen. I think it's called on the screen. I said screen. I think it's called Cosmetics Box NG or something like that. And I really love it. It's quite sturdy. I bought it and some other things from them. And it's quite sturdy. I love it so much. This makeup is not arranged now. I just brought them out of here. I've had this box for a long time. I just brought it out of here. This thing is actually rust. I don't think it can go. Actually rust, but yeah, I want to wash this. This is where I normally store my makeup.
but I want to wash this. I've cleaned all this makeup and disinfected them, so they're just here drying. When this one is clean, I'm going to now transfer some here and leave some here and then add some other things here as well. But I really love it. I'm still going to buy more things from them. I even told Linda I'm going to buy more things from her because I love her service. I also love, you know, how fast the items came. Even though it came through GIG, it was packaged well, and I love her customer service. So you guys should go and check her out if you're looking for. I think she has this on her page as well, but I didn't buy this from her. I've had this one for a very long time. But yeah, she has it on her page. She has this, she has jewelry boxes and other stuff like that. I absolutely love it. So yeah, you guys, I don't know, my eyes are clear now. I don't know if I've said on my channel before, but I notice that sometimes when I do makeup, I always have red eyes the next day. Red, itchy, and watery eyes. Like, it would be really paining, not pain, discomfort, okay? I won't call it actual pain, but you know when your eyes are just feeling very sensitive? Yeah, it happens to me from time to time when I do makeup, but I didn't really know what was causing it. And I said it on my second channel, Adesis Reviews. I said it yesterday. Yeah, I said it there yesterday because when I was filming my last video there, my eyes were still sensitive there. So when I said it, Soti Mama, Soti Special, here on YouTube, she commented and said I might be allergic to the latex in my mascara. First of all, I didn't know that there was latex in mascara. Second of all, I'm actually allergic to latex. Like, if I stay near balloons, latex balloons, is there any other type of balloon? Anyway, if I stay near balloons, my nose will be itching, my eyes will be itching, you know, my ears, I just have itching on my face especially. So whenever I blow balloons, I make sure I wash my hands immediately. I remember one time I carried balloons in my car and we drove for a while. By the time I got to my destination, my whole face, you know, inside the car now with, you know, windows closed, my whole face was itching me. So I definitely know I'm allergic to latex. I'm so glad she said that because I'm going to try out the mascara alone. Maybe tomorrow, not today, because I'm not even in the mood to deal with that. I'm going to try the mascara alone today and see if it happens. If it happens, I'm going to throw away the mascara because I've eliminated, I don't think I've eliminated mascara. I have. But I'll try, Sha. I know that I've eliminated eye pencil before. It's not, you know, it didn't change anything. At some point, I was thinking maybe it's eyeshadow that drops on my eyes and starts paining me. But I don't have any old eyeshadow. I don't even have any old makeup. And I always clean my makeup and disinfect it. I have this Too Sure. What's the name, spray here. So I always spray down my makeup. I always clean them with soap and water and then spray them down. So I don't know exactly what it is. Okay, I don't disinfect inside the makeup, Sha. Like the mascara, I don't disinfect the inside. So I don't know, but anyway, I'll try and figure it out. My eyes are even still itching me, but I don't think it's as red as it was yesterday. And yeah, you guys, today is Saturday. I have a lot to do. I'm actually supposed to go for a birthday party today, but to be honest, I don't think I can. Like, my social bandwidth has been exhausted. I have exhausted, you know, the space I have for social activities. I need to arrange my house. A lot of things are not in place. Besides that, my kids are now fully home. Hey, God, dude. They've closed from school, so I'm not even going to have as much time as I used to have. Because they are going to be at home now 24/7. And there's no holiday lesson. I tried to look for a holiday lesson for them, but I did not see. Even though maybe I'll still try, but or maybe their school might do holiday lesson. Hey, I hope they do. But yeah, so because of it, I need to just take out today and really arrange things around the house. Tomorrow I'll go to church, and then when I come back, I'll now sleep. So today is not even for sleep for me. Tomorrow I'll now sleep because even Ada and Nello, oh, I'm supposed to film tomorrow. Anyway, Nello is back. If you guys don't know, Nello traveled to Abuja and she's back now. So we also need to film content for Ada and Nello. You guys, we are so sorry. In fact, that channel, don't worry. Very soon, you guys are going to be proud of us. Okay, very soon, because we're coming fully. We're coming back fully now. She's now around, as in from now for a while, she's now around. And me, I have stabilized a bit, you know, with myself. So I'm sure we're going to have time now to film more. Our kids are not going to school, but we'll find a way. Maybe all our kids will stay in her house while we film here. Then when we're done, I'll go and pick my kids. I think that's what we're going to do, just so that we can keep up with putting out content for you guys. Like, you people should not even think that we are taking you guys for granted or we're not serious and all of that. You know, we are moms, we have our own personal channels, and we have other things that we are doing, social events, families need us, you know. It's a lot, okay? It's a lot. Anybody that tells you being a mom is easy, it's not easy. And one thing about being a mom, we don't just want to end as being a mom. We want to as well still, you know, pursue our hobbies, pursue, you know, money making activities, also be there for our families, be there for our friends, be there for, you know, social events and stuff. So it's not easy, but thankfully we have enough help. And you know, actually we don't have enough help, let me not even lie, we don't have enough help, but we did try, sha. Anyway, that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you guys enjoyed watching today's video, and I'll see you all in my next one.